Our Lady of Perpetual Health, pray for us.
Please be seated.
In a moment, we recite the Triduum prayers to our Mother of Perpetual Health for the second day of the Triduum. Today is the actual feast day of the miraculous icon, Our Lady of Perpetual Health. Today as well, we mark the beginning of the indulgence devotion of the 15 Saturdays of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary. Remember that each of the 15 Saturdays we receive Holy Communion with an intention to make this devotion, and in particular to honor and meditate upon one of the mysteries of the Rosary. Today's first mystery then is that of the Annunciation. Be it done unto me according to thy word. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. There could be no more fitting rosary mystery, surely, than that of the Annunciation, to meditate upon this day of Our Lady of Perpetual Health. And a wonderful way to begin this rosary devotion is simply to look at the picture of Our Lady of Perpetual Health, to meditate a little bit upon what happens in this biblical mystery. That is to say, that you recall how in the Annunciation, the angel Gabriel, who is pictured there on the icon along with Michael, the angel Gabriel comes to the Mother of God. She is saluted by him and turbata at. She's troubled at his saying, and the angel says to her, "Fear not, O Mary, thou hast found favor with God. Thou shalt conceive and bear a son." The other day we had the feast, and we still keep the octave now, of St. John the Baptist, when the Annunciation was made to his father, Zachary, in the temple by the same great Gabriel. He doubted from some natural reason, simply because of old age, but not so the most prudent Virgin Mary. She does not doubt. She is troubled in her humility, and at the same time she is mindful of the vow, the supernatural promise that she has made to Almighty God of her virginity. And Gabriel sets all of her doubts at rest by telling her that this is God's will, that she should be overshadowed by the power of the Almighty, and that she should conceive and bear a son. And she bows down before the divine design and says, "Be it done unto me according to thy word." The Annunciation, first joyful mystery. So then gaze at the icon and consider that this is called by the Greeks Our Lady of the Sorrowful Vision. How our Lord, her divine son, a little child, a toddler, sees Gabriel and Michael coming with the instruments of the Passion, the reminder that he must suffer and die all of the bitter sorrows of Good Friday for our eternal welfare, that this is God's will. And he is troubled, as was his mother once. He is full of fear. And what does he do? What we must do. He runs to Our Lady. He finds refuge there in her arms. He's looking at the two angels and the instruments of the Passion, but he's clutching Mary's hand. So too must you and I do when the Annunciation comes to us of some sorrow God wills us to suffer. Now, very often in life, the instruments of our suffering are not borne by angels, but even by devils. But God permits that devils should try and tempt us for our own eternal welfare, for reparation for our sins, for all sorts of good. So whether it be a devil or merely some human means, it is an angel, a messenger of God's will, that it should be so. Meditate upon this today, as you want to be like our divine Savior, to run to the Mother of Perpetual Help and to find refuge there in her arms. Last of all, there's that charming detail that is to be seen at the bottom of the icon. You have to get close, look over the candles and the flowers, but you see that the infant's sandal has fallen off. We remember that on the one hand that means how quickly we must turn to Mary so that we may say yes to God, how we hold her hand, and in the rush sometimes our sandal might even fall off. But the profound scriptural meaning of the sandal coming off of our Lord's foot is that in the Old Testament, to remove your shoes was a sign of willing servitude, of profound reverence. I will serve thee. I will obey thee. That's why God told Moses in the Old Testament, take off your shoes. This is a holy place. That's one of the reasons why we take off our shoes to creep to the cross on Good Friday. The Old Testament concept, the symbolism, the taking off of the shoes stands for the yielding of one's rights to another and the wish to be treated as a servant. Just as Mary says at the first joyful mystery, "Be it done unto me according to thy word." And last of all, in the book of Deuteronomy, there's another meaning, that is to say, a readiness for reproach and for infamy. And that takes us back again to Gabriel and to Michael, the instruments of the Passion. What God the Father has prepared for his Son, made man, he is now ready to accept and to say yes to. He can do that because he's in Mary's arms. He can do that because he's holding her hand. So can you. Make then your good resolutions today as we make our first of the 15 Saturdays of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary. Now we sing a verse of Mother Dearest, Mother Fairest, and then we recite together the second of the prayers to the Mother of Perpetual Help. The novena cards are to be found in the back of the church as you enter. Mother Dearest, Mother Fairest,
God forever.